In this video, we will talk about the time-independent Schrödinger equation in quantum mechanics. If we start with the time-dependent Schrödinger equation, we can get to the time-independent one by performing a separation of variables on the wave function, where we claim that the time dependence is entirely contained inside this exponential function. Such a state is called a stationary state, because the distribution over space does not change with time. The difference between two wave functions at different times is just a different phase. Therefore, if we calculate the probability distribution of psi of x and t, it will not depend on time, and this is why we call it a stationary state. If we use this separation ansatz in the time-dependent Schrödinger equation, we can easily perform the time derivative and then cancel the exponential from both sides of the equation, since it is just a complex number and no operator is acting on it anymore. By the way, that's exactly why we cannot cancel psi on both sides of the equation, because the Hamiltonian operator is acting on psi. If the Hamiltonian would be something simple like a derivative, then we would have the equation h bar omega psi equals the derivative of psi. And you can see that we cannot cancel psi in this case. Now back to the Schrödinger equation. If we investigate the factors here, we notice that they have units of energy, so we can collect them in a new variable called E for energy. This leads to a very simple looking eigenvalue problem. H psi is equal to E psi, where H is an operator and E is the eigenvalue, so just a number. And since the time-independent Schrödinger equation is an eigenvalue problem, we can actually determine both the wave function psi of x as well as the eigenenergy E. So, in order to calculate something, we need to specify how the Hamiltonian of a quantum system looks like. Once we fix the Hamiltonian, we can start solving the eigenvalue problem. But that's pretty much it for this video. Thanks for watching.